Well, hello everyone and welcome to today's Word at One. And as you know, we are spending a wee bit of time just reading some Psalms. And today I have got Christine who is kindly going to read Psalm 145 for us. And following Christine's reading, we've got another clip from Ian White, an audio clip. And it's Ian's version of Psalm 145. And Psalm 145 sings about how worthy the Lord is. He is worthy to be praised. And as we were hearing in a fairly recent sermon from Kenny in Revelation, it talks about the song that the elders will sing is just how worthy Jesus is, worthy, ever worthy, ever worthy. It's a never-ending song. And isn't that amazing? And even in the Psalms, we also hear about this, how worthy the Lord is. And so I'll leave you with Christine and we'll have a short prayer at the end.
Everyone, I'm going to read Psalm 145. I will extol you, my God, O King, and I will bless your name forever and ever. Every day I will bless you and I will praise your name forever and ever. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable. One generation shall praise your works to another and shall declare your mighty acts. I will meditate on the glorious splendour of your majesty and on your wondrous works. Men shall speak of the might of your awesome acts, and I will declare your greatness. They shall utter the memory of your great goodness and shall sing of your righteousness. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and great in mercy. The Lord is good to all, and his tender mercies are over all his works. All your works shall praise you, O Lord, and your saints shall bless you. They shall speak of the glory of your kingdom and talk of your power, to make known to the sons of men his mighty acts and the glorious majesty of his kingdom. Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and your dominion endures throughout all generations. The Lord upholds all who fall and raises up all who are bowed down. The eyes of all look expectantly to you, and you give them their food in due season. You open your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing. The Lord is righteous in all his ways, gracious in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him, to all who call upon him in truth. He will fulfill the desire of those who fear him. He also will hear their cry and save them. The Lord preserves all who love him, but all the wicked he will destroy. My mouth shall speak the praise of the Lord, and all flesh shall bless his holy name forever and ever.
Thanks very much, Christine. And let's just have a wee prayer together, folks. Father, we just want to come before you and thank you once again. Thank you, Lord, that you are worthy. Thank you, Lord, that as your word declares, Lord, you are loving towards all you have made, and that's us. And Lord, thank you that we will never understand, we'll never be able to fathom the depths of your love. It's beyond our understanding. Lord, thank you that you love us like that, with that immeasurable love. And Lord, thank you that that means we can trust you. Lord, that we can put our hand in yours, knowing that your plans for us are for good. And that, Lord, even when what we see immediately in front of us doesn't appear to echo that, Lord, we know that in the long run, your plans for us are good. And so help us, Lord, to fix our eyes on you and keep our eyes fixed on you in these days. Thank you, Lord, that you have indeed promised never to leave us or forsake us, never to leave us alone. And Lord, thank you that we can trust that too, that you are always with us. So bless you, Lord, in the precious name of Jesus. Amen. Well, God bless you all today, everyone, and here's Ian.